right. Our cue popped after a few minutes for the Dying Gasp, the trial where we fight Emmett Selk as Hades. So we have this massive...
Show me your vaunted strength, and I shall expose the lie of your fragmented existence.
Massive humanoid body, humanoid shape, left fist seems to have... There's just massive dark energy, a massive staff, kind of a nautiloid. Yeah. We'll see. And we started. I'll try to keep track of what happens. There are videos that are better than mine will be as far as Ravenous Assault or Ravenous Assault, I think it's a Tank Buster. Yeah, he did it. No problem.
Darkness reigns.
Bad faith. Shit. That was tough to understand, but it only it put up cones of attack on its sides.
You are unworthy.
Double is gonna, cause we have some spread out shit going on here. As is tradition, everybody go get back to the middle. Broken faith. Gosh dang it! Okay, we have a bunch of circles summoned around the outside. There'll be these platforms falling to the ground. Just you don't want to be near them when they fall and explode because the AoE is pretty massive. So a lot of running here. Medica 2, some thin but long cone attacks, and then it will appear again in the spots where you were safe. Ravenous Assault again, Tank Buster on my Gunbreaker. My shield did a good job with that. The other healer, we're both white mages, a bunch of hot. Bad Faith, don't. And I think where those are, spread out mechanic, and now he is untargetable. Give voice to your anguish, my brethren. And there's gonna be some ads. The ads are very easy to kill. They die pretty quickly. Just if you gather them up, like you barely even have to gather them. They die so fast. Even the video I watched 2 years ago, they die so fast. If you have a get away from each other mechanic, don't stack with the stack mechanic. It should be pretty simple to understand, but sometimes people are dumb, so. What this person said in chat is correct. Like, this fight is easy. It was easy 2 years ago. It's easier now that gear has outpaced everything, so just don't stack when you shouldn't stack, spread out when you should spread out, it's that easy. My girlfriend is texting, but I have just joined this fight, so I cannot participate in the texting of her. I have full mana, and I haven't had to use a healing spell in a long time. Like, yawn wide the ever-hungering void. Devour the light and return all to darkness. Why did I take so much damage? Impressive resilience, but it matters little. I have all...
stifled by this vessel of flesh!
Eternity to break your stubborn will. We have darkness on the screen. I'm gonna join everybody here in the center-ish area. I shall bear every hope, every dream, even prayer. Masks around this dark purple roiling energy area. And then on the side we have Hades. So everything will happen from this side. Raised up by the prayers of my fallen
friend. Behold, a sorcerer!
son of Eld, tremble before my glory.
So the tanks should spread to either side, or both to one side, so that the ensuing line attacks aren't going to be a problem. But the tanks aren't doing that, so it is what it is. Shadow Stream. We're about to find out what that does with the tanks all, yeah, fucking like shit. Dude, don't run into people, man. Like, do you not understand how this shit works? My god. Okay, get behind this fist that he raises down. Arm, sorry, not fist. Oh fuck, I fell off. I didn't know you could fall off. The video didn't tell me I could fall off, but you could fall off, so that's awesome. I'm gonna die from this fuck. God damn it. Okay. I'm gonna spread out here. Not off the fucking thingy. I'm stunned. And I'm floated into the middle. Man. Am I the only one who's in this? So everybody else has to defeat this ethereal gale, jail, whatever you want to call it. Dual strike, I'm not entirely sure what that does, but it looks like I'm targeted. Spread out mechanic. Like, oh, no, please don't run into me. Please don't run, dude, don't fucking run into me. I have, like, no health, man. Come on.
This place will be your tomb.
I don't know what this is. Have at least one person in each of those. Okay, you've been rezzed. I was about to rez you, but somebody else did that. Well, the only other healer, maybe a red mage or summoner. We have a knockback, so go to the edge where the knockback starts from. I would just be the best bet. Again, not the video I watched. Fuck, dude. Shadow Stream? Is that the middle only? Yep, it definitely was. Awesome. So good at this game. Titanomancy is just AoE unavoidable, I think. Yep. Cone attack. So the tanks are both standing on the same side. I got that one. Life in captivity. Like, this video is not good for anybody. Okay. We're all bound. We're all spread out. My dominant brethren, dream now of a dark tomorrow. By our gathered might, must we reclaim vain reflections. And he blasts the circular platform we're on with dark energy. We are now in literal dark. This is also not in the video I watched, so I have no idea. Just click literally anything and, like, press buttons, click your mouse buttons, everything you can. Has the Warden's Light won free? No.
Damn you. Damn your
wretched blessing. And, oh shit. Oh fuck. Wait. Just don't kill us. I'm not done. Oh, you can go fuck yourself and stop trying to kill us all. You want to stand in the middle, in the light. Otherwise, like, this platform starts to become smaller and smaller. FYI, you did already know. And done. Wowzies. well rocked, everybody. Good job, tank. Healer's already gone, who rezzed me, so I can't. We're gonna have a cutscene probably after this. Check, check. We have darkness. We have the floating platform.
I will not yield.
I will not yield, is what we hear. Dark purple, black energy.
Should I surrender this fight? What will become of it all?
One mask, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What will become of our triumphs, our hopes, our despair? What of this anguish which yet burns in my breast even after the passing of eons? No, 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 I will not let it all be written up. And these masks are summoned, are like pulled into this big mask which becomes Hades again. Claws, gigantic claws and wings outstretched
enough,
toward you.
Damn you!
Thancred becomes like this flash of light that comes down and dodges and rolls and weaves and ducks and throws the Aurasite and breaks it into shards and slams it into Hades in several places. Great shard shatters and light crystals glow from Hades on each shatter site, and this dark purple wind is coming from Hades, and the scions.
Infernal strength!
The scions are all holding up one hand each toward Hades' light and to help against the wind. But now everybody seems to be struck. Halsey and Alphino help each other, thrust their arms at once again for light to shine. Green is there too, helping that light shine. Pulses of light shining. Like over and over and over and over and over into Hades.
Now! Strike with all thy might!
And now there is one beam of light from Hades' like midsection. And I nod when Ariante says that. And Hades tries to grasp that like beam, that pole arm of light. And from our hand emits one more beam of light. We hold up. And Hades is trying to pry that. Oh, Hades shatters that glass light spear and bathes everyone into darkness, excluding myself. And I hold up, I'm glowing with light, I have that one arm, I summon a light great axe and I thrust it toward Hades, where this slash of blinding light emits from his midsection. Pulses. Darkness again, and now pulses one last time with a beam of light across Hades' body. The screen goes white, then black, and now we are back to us on this purple stone platform. The glowing white light great axe is beyond Emmett Selk. We can see through a giant hole in Emmett Selk's body. He is wearing the black robes of an Asian.
Remember. Remember us.
He is glowing, sparkling, that hole in his chest still there.
Remember that we once lived.
Yeah, dude. No problem there. People live and people die. That's how it works. We will die soon, probably. He smiles once more before he bursts into light energy that does not go into us. Pretty important to note, I would say. Just disperses into the world.
It's over. Emmett Selk is no more.
It would seem that way.
More importantly, how do you fare?
I don't know yet. Ishtola is looking at us.
What dost thou see?
With her sight.
Her ether. It is as it used to be. As a disciple of Zodiac, the Ascian was the darkness to your light. I can but assume that when you set your strength against his, the light within you was spent.
No, it's more than that. Under the strain of that incredible flood of ether, your soul had begun to break apart. Yet now it seems somehow restored. I tried to help you before the battle, but Emmett Selk stopped me. So, how did you... Exactly what did you... Can you tell us what happened?
We look back to the great axe made of light that was beyond Emmett Selk, and now it bursts into ether specks and goes into the world. I had help from a hero of this world, or I'll explain it another time. I'm choosing the first one because it's the best one, in my opinion.
I see.
Do you, Rain, really? The Exarch stumbles up to us. Still standing. Seems weak, though.
Where to start? I believe I owe you all an apology, and you most especially.
My options are let's get out of here first, or I'm tired, we'll leave the lecture for later, or 'tis good to see you awake, Grahatia. Tis good to see you awake, Grahatia. It's my choice. He looks. His teeth are trembling. Seems like he's crying. He does indeed cry.
Well, tis good to be awake.
So, those mad souls dove straight into the ocean over there, did they?
All I could see from here was the whale, Master Chai.
'Twas surely Alfano and those friends of his. They did something heroic, mark my words.
Says Dulia Chai.
You need only look up there for proof of that.
I have to pee. I didn't know this would be this long. Oh, it's still only like 20 minutes. Not yet.
As you say, my love.
China's.
They're sure to be back. Any moment now. Any moment.
They're all looking over the water at the docks, which we have once gathered materials from.
They are coming back, aren't they? I couldn't bear the thought of...
She starts to cry into her...
There, dear.
Hands
everything will be all right.
With rings of multiple gemstones.
Greetings!
You all right?
Welcome back!
Oh yeah, we do indeed have... I'm gonna pee during this because I got nothing to click. Sorry, I'm not gonna describe what's going on, but we see the sun in the sky. It's not like everlasting light. There's no shell of light. It's just the sun and clouds and blue sky.
I didn't think we'd be swimming the whole way back.
And the scions have washed on the shore with me.
Heavens, take me.
They and we are all tired.
Alphano! Oh, hells.
Wait! Where's Urianche?
He must have fallen behind.
But shouldn't we look for him?
He'll wash up sooner or later.
For the love of... Alphano!
Welcome back, dear ones!
And thus did salvation come to the first. The lamps of Amaroth will fade along with Emmet Selk's enchantments, and the depths shall be as once they were.
Every freaking game forevermore should have pause buttons. Because people have to pee, people have to... It's annoying as shit.
Mount Gulg will one day fall, and the Talos below yield to wind and rain. This tale, too, will fade with time, passing into legend as the world heals and moves on. Nevertheless,
the screen goes black. We see the Crystal Tower.
As ether obeys the cycle, as death and decay gives way to new life.
We see Ardbert walking along the bridge to the Crystarium. And I don't think the people of the Crystarium can see him.
So too do the memories we share inspire others to rise to greatness.
We see those people are replaced.
For we who walk before may lead those who walk after.
The glowing ghosts of the previous warriors of light.
Your road goes ever on, as does your story, as does your legacy.
And then Ardbert is replaced by myself and the Scions, being greeted by the cheers of the actual living people of the Crystarium. We are now at the... Like...
Such is the hero's lot, to touch the lives of countless others.
The big open space that is to the west of the...
Excuse me? You're the Warrior of Darkness, aren't you?
The Exarch's, like, main door.
Where are you from, really? And how did you get to be so strong?
You hold a finger to your lips, as if it's a secret. The screen goes black. And I'm assuming the credits are about to roll. Now, I think I do a little bit of nail cutting here. Final Fantasy XIV, Shadowbringers. We have our voice cast. What's the number two? Oh, yeah, we'll speed it up. I don't remember if it was on Twitter or on Instagram, but like, there was something about the voice of Grahatia and how keeping that particular voice actor, like that voice actor has gone on to actually act in real shows. I don't know what show it was, but there was some kind of a struggle to keep him on as a voice actor, but at some point he said, like, I'm invested in this story. The story in Final Fantasy XIV is amazing. I cannot picture myself not being a part of it. It's like something to that effect, like, he was like, I'm not going to abandon this role even if I have this other actual, like, in, like, live action person acting role. That's pretty. I agree. I like the stories of this game. I mean, even what some considered like the bad opening storyline, more or less pre-ARR, which is what, A Realm Reborn? Sorry for that sound. That's my fucking chair on the mat that I have. I bought a mat for a roller chair, and then I had a roller chair for a while, and that roller chair just decided to start breaking. So now I have a wicker chair that I have to be very careful about how I maneuver it so as not to make super crazy sounds. All we have is credits and some kind of like flashback scenes. I'm gonna go check on my pork belly. I'll be back. Not that it matters, because there's nothing to talk about here.
one world's end as a new begin, and should our souls scatter unto the wind, still we shall live on. Stand tall.
Gosh, we are back a few minutes later, and it's still not... Oh gosh, dang it, I left my drink. Be right back again. Thank you. screen has been black for a while now, but I'm afraid to progress it further. Because this game has been known to have what some might consider quote-unquote after the credit videos, scenarios, FMVs, cutscenes, etc. So I have it on double. Like, double speed is about the best we're gonna get. You can't, oh my gosh, it'd be so nice if you could just like press like the right arrow key on your keyboard to skip 5 seconds or skip 10 seconds or whatever, just like in YouTube or, oh god, that'd be so nice. I would be skipping quite a bit though. Through to make sure my videos are comprehensive. Boredom. It's just boredom. Boredom is what I go through. That's nothing special. Like, people this day and age can't just sit with their thoughts, you know? It's me. I can't sit with my thoughts. I don't like my thoughts. I don't like them at all. So, please, for the love of all that's holy, get me out of this hell. No, I'm cool. It's cool. I have meat, pork belly, that I'm waiting to reach a particular level of cookedness in the oven. Yeah, that's exactly what I literally just said. Why? So I hate it when people don't read what I said, or like, especially a person that I am in love with, who is in love with me. Like, for fuck's sake, I literally just told you that, yeah, I could take it out of the oven because I'm about to cut it into cubes anyway and put it in a pan. We've reached the 43-minute mark, and I I do not recall any past expansions. Like, this particular fight, like the dungeon itself, the quest that I am on, the story quest I'm on, and I suppose I will have finished by the end of this frickin' credit scrolling, didn't tell me, hey, you should probably set aside a certain amount of time because this is the last one. There will be credits that you might want to experience. There might even be a post-credits cutscene. It's like they don't want to spoil... Anyway, the credits are done. It ain't over. Let's do this. So, we're talking to the Crystal Exarch inside the... No, what's this called? The Ocular. There we go. It's been a while since I've been in here. The Scions are here as well. Cutscene, talking to the Exarch. Please talk. Please talk so I don't have to. Please. It's after the credits. Please talk.
By your deeds has the blinding light been banished from these skies, and the Sin Eaters driven to retreat. Although our many hurts will be years in the mending, I have faith that this world and her people will one day be whole once more. With no rejoining in prospect, the Source need no longer fear the coming of an eighth Umbral calamity.
So our home source world thingy is okay.
And with that triumph, the future from which you came will no longer come to pass. Yet here you still stand.
Yeah.
So I do.
Time travel.
I wonder if that other age continues onward somehow, cut adrift from time's flow. Or have I simply etched myself a place upon this new block of history? Either way, this is an unexpected development. As the summoner of your souls, my death was meant to release you back to your world. Yet I am very much alive, and you are still stuck here in the first.
I believe I speak for us all when I say that we are happy to postpone our return if it means your life is spared. We will seek out another way.
Besides, I never had any intention of rushing home. There are people here I still need to thank, and this means I might actually have time to do so.
Yet we dare not neglect our comrades in the Source. Mistress Tataru, to name but one, will be most anxious to know how things stand with us.
It'll probably, at this point, only have been like an hour or 2 hours. Like, the flow of time is crazy here in comparison to the Source where we are from, so...
So, you'll just have to make the journey alone for the moment. Be sure and give a full report to our fellow Scions, will you? Oh, and we'd also appreciate any news you can bring us from back home.
Again, time dilation, whatever. But I nod.
Then I see no reason to delay. I can open the path from here.
Yep, let's go, sure.
I imagine we each have matters demanding our attention, so let this be a farewell for us all.
Oh my god, are one of you gonna stay here?
Send word when you've resummoned our friend.
Are more than one of you gonna stay here? I can't...
Oh, and do try to ensure she arrives within the city next time.
Heyo.
Of course! I shall strive for utmost accuracy. No strange forests or unplanned passengers, I promise.
Some laughter around the Scions, a bow from Ordeon Che, a shrug from Alcee, some nods and other kind of like half shrugs from the rest of them.
I'm a little relieved, to be honest. I would have been terribly lonely if everyone had suddenly disappeared.
Oh, Rean. Are you staying here? Are you coming with? I don't know what your future has. I'm sorry. I still don't know.
But I understand that you have to go. Safe journey, Warrior of Darkness. I hope to see you again soon.
I don't know what happens to her.
Just a moment while I attune the portal. Then you can be on your way.
Turns his back to us, walks toward...
When I was a boy, many long years ago...
The back wall, where there is like an...
I yearned to stand tall as the heroes of Eld.
Kind of like a setup portal kind of thing in the wall.
But like a fool seeking to pluck the stars from the heavens, my every attempt to reprise their deeds fell short. And then one day, an all but forgotten dream from my youth stood before me in the flesh.
I hope this ends soon, because I have food in the fucking oven that I need to take care of really soon.
A hero who looked at the horizon and beyond and saw I knew not what. All I knew was that I would give anything to stand at that hero's side.
I walk through the portal he created, and he reaches out try to touch it, but it seems to shock him.
Would that it was so easy.
Yeah.
The glory of the heavens was ever beyond the grasp of those who never thought to reach for it. But if I have gained anything from all of this, it is the courage to stretch out my hand. Do you hear me, Grahatia?
Wait.
This is no time for sleeping.
You're not Grahatia? Wait, what? Hold on. What? What? Are you talking... Are you talking to Grahatia... who became the Crystal Tower? Meanwhile, in the Imperial Palace in the Source, we have a black screen. And now we see like an overhead lighting in a corridor hallway with a bunch of figures running. One of which is Gaius, and I think Astinian next to him, and Gaius's people. They come across 5 dead Imperial soldiers, says Astinian. Been a while since I've seen you guys. He kneels next to a dead.
To the West Gate! I want to know what's happening there!
Gaius says to his 2 compatriots who go running off.
Same as the others, struck down with a single blow. An unfortunate day to draw guard duty. Forgive me. These were your people.
We took advantage of this slaughter to slip into the palace. 'Tis not for me to grieve them. That was the Emperor!
Okay, I'll be right back. I'm just gonna take my... so we have some time. Here we go now. Here and now.
Wait! Ugh!
Gaius goes rushing toward a large double door. Nestinian following after, but urging caution.
Uranians!
When they breach the door, Gaius... There's a dead soldier on the ground. A close to dead king.
Gaius! You've missed your part in this, I'm afraid.
Like that vampire looking king guy. And there's a sword in his stomach. Held by...
Identify yourself, demon!
Elidibus in the body of... What's his name? Xenos? I think Xenos, right?
You were hoping for the Ascian?
Oh, shit.
The Craven shed this skin and fled rather than face me. A pity. I was looking forward to crossing blades with myself.
Huh. So Xenos has stabbed his father.
But I cannot deny the feeling of satisfaction. Body and soul reunited at last.
What now? The game continues, but the pieces have changed.
Only if we trust in a paragon's words. A mistake I do not intend to repeat.
Why is Gaius's skin basically fucking like charcoal colored? What's that about? With his gun
Gaius!
Blade. But the...
He speaks the truth.
But Varus, the dying king, is speaking.
Elidibus is gone. Tore a hole into the rift. Xenos, my foolish, greedy son. Was a second life not enough? Was the Empire too rich a prize to ignore?
Varus plucks the sword out of his stomach.
True freedom for our nation, our people, will never be won by a spoiled princeling. The burden of this throne is beyond you.
So he thrust the sword out, broke off the last 4 or 5 inches and tossed it aside before saying that.
Tis you, father, who have struggled with this burden. Simply holding the Empire together has occupied your limited faculties. But you may take comfort in knowing that I have no intention of pursuing your tedious agenda. Nor am I interested in ruling over the Empire's lands. I came only to remove that which ruins my sport. I will not have my prey stolen by your petty wars and cowardly weapons.
Like the chemical weapons that we're talking about? I didn't think that Varus... He raises the sword hand...
You would kill me just for that.
...into the air with a broken sword.
I need no other reason.
Screen flashes dark.
Any and all who interfere with my hunt.
And then, you can only see, kind of the outlines and stuff of Xenos as he says this.
Will not do so twice!
His right eye flashes red before he strikes, killing Varus with his broken sword.
I heard the Ascians speak of Zodiac, an eidolon. Even the will of this star is but a construct of our own making.
He's looking up to the sky when he says that. Eyes
we
wide.
Shall gorge upon their strength, and then, my friend,
crazy,
our contest shall begin anew.
looks fucking psycho.
Xenos!
Gaius charges Xenos. Swipes at him, but the screen goes black. So we have no idea what happens. Okay. I gotta continue because it ain't over yet, apparently. Shadowbringers, I'm still working on it. Travel to North Silver Tier, sure. I don't know. Mordana. Oh my god, dude. It's been so long since I've been in Mordana. Let's go. Yeah, Revenant's Toll, 100G. Let's go. Forgot which thing was which. Wait. Okay, hold on. Oh, you're down here. Yeah, you're in the fucking rising. Yeah. I don't know why my. Yeah. Anyway, sorry. Rising stones. We shall enter if I can click the. Alcohol, yo. Hey, Tataru. Been a fucking long time. How you doing? Cutscene. She's stretching to the sky. Wait, why are you walking away from me? And she runs back. But, Mercy, is it really you? You raise a hand. But how? When? We didn't think you'd be back for ages. Time moves in mysterious ways. Or would you rather I went again? I'm gonna go with time moves in mysterious ways. Right, so it does. The reports you had delivered by that excitable little pixie said as much. What? As for the situation on this side, the Imperials are still eyeing our forces from afar. From what I'm told, the Garlean armies have been slow to react and seem reluctant to commit to any large-scale engagements. It's an odd sort of stalemate. Otherwise, we've yet to see any sign of that awful Black Rose weapon we were warned about. Oh, but I suppose we did call in an old friend to help out on that account. Sid? Who? I haven't seen Sid in a while. Kral and I had a terrible time tracking him down. Though it will be worth it to see the look on your face when you find out who it is. Anyway, I was just about to make contact with this helper of ours, and then confirm the latest news from the front. Might you fancy having a rest while I do? I haven't done her voice in a while, so I'm so sorry. Ah, the Warrior of Light, back where she belongs? Just as if nothing had happened? Though, you do seem different somehow. You'll have to tell me all about your adventures when you next have a spare moment. Until then, welcome back. Shadowbringers is complete. It gives us a wind-up Graha Tia as a minion, a Tomorrow and Tomorrow orchestration role, and we're done. Fucking finally. Are there extra cutscenes? There are. Of course there fucking are, right? Yeah. Here we go. We see basically like a moon landscape, just white moon rock everywhere, and a white robed Ascian, Elidibus. Oblivion has claimed him, says Elidibus. Red half mask on the eyes. Emmet Selk gone. Lahabrea gone. I alone remain, the last of the unbroken. Once more, I am moved to reevaluate the potential of these tattered souls. Screen flashes white. We have a backstory here. Ah, Xenos. Never did I dream you could overpower me so completely, possessed as I was of your body and all its uncanny strength. And now that I have shared with you the truth of this world and its reflections, who can predict how events will unfold? Not I. white screen flash back to present. Emissary. What a poor jest that title has become. The flow of history has become muddied, its currents wild beyond my capacity to direct them. Fuck, it's been like an hour and 5 minutes almost. Elidibus is on the moon, basically. We can see Earth, basically. You've wrested the advantage, Heidelin. The thieving hands of your disciples tighten their grip on our star. The origins of the world remain hidden and its inhabitants ignorant of their broken existence, just as you and your creators desired. They celebrate the gift of an imperfect life, uncaring, unknowing as we weaken and fade. He takes a knee and touches the moon ground, but do not imagine yourself rid of us. Though your champion has indeed proven the most egregious obstacle to our ascendance, a barbed thorn in my side, she may yet be removed and cast into the abyss. Oh yes, it can be done. I will keep these heroes mired in the first, and victory will be ours at the last. He stands. Warriors of darkness now, are they? Then their fate is decided. They shall meet the same end as those who came before. Death at the hands of warriors of light. He smiles. The screen goes behind him as we kind of see the moon and then the quote-unquote Earth, you know, beyond the moon in the... Yeah. And now we are in a really bright land with Thancred and Reen. Kind of like a salt flats kind of area. With a normal sky with clouds and blue sky. It seems you are right, says Thancred. Reen nods. Yes, there is something out there. But it would mean crossing moms and moms of this infernal emptiness, which is rather unhealthy for living creatures, as I understand it. Even were we to restrict ourselves to brief forays, I don't like to imagine the effect it would have on our ether. But you still want to go, don't you? We may have saved the world, but we haven't reclaimed it. When you put it that way. What choice do we have? She smiles at him. He looks at her. Well, of course I'm going with you. That's what family is for, isn't it? Come, let's head back and prepare for this mad journey of yours. Thank you, Thancred. They make their way across this white, like sandy salt flats kind of area towards something. The screen goes black. Still like white sand that we're looking at here, white sandy hills. Though blazing skies give way to gentle night, what hand can end the war of dark and light? Black screen, kind of orangish letters. Trust parties have been unlocked. By completing the main scenario quest, Shadowbringers, you have unlocked the trust system. Trust allows you to repeat previously completed main scenario dungeons with a party of NPC avatars, who will gain experience and level up in accordance with their duty participation. To bring up the interface, select Trust under Duty from the main menu. For more information, please refer to the help found within the interface itself. Okay. Furthermore, bolstered by your experiences in the first, you are now able to accept new quests from job-related NPCs in the source. In order to access them, the following conditions must be met. Level 80 in a job, complete the relevant level 70 job quests, complete the associated role quest line, quest locations and other details, blah, blah, blah. In addition, quests to unlock new content have now become available in the Crystarium, Rest well, warrior of light and darkness, for two worlds of adventure await your return. Oh my gosh. Finally done, I think, with Shadowbringers. That's the end of this video. I have a lot of cooking to do, and it's fucking already 7:30, and I'm not going to be able to... The sponsor, non-sponsor for this video is Sparkling Ice, 17-ounce per bottle, 12-pack. I choose strawberry lemonade, zero sugar, fantastic flavors, whatever you choose, a great keto drink choice. If you purchase it with the link in my description, I'll get a small cut. I'll see you next time.